Observability is increasingly required of our systems as we work to improve reliability. Metrics represent the health of your system over time and are a crucial component of observability. And while services running in GCP benefit from out-of-the-box platform instrumentation, it's often necessary to add more. Today, we'll take a look at how to do that with OpenCensus and Stackdriver. This is the Stack Doctor. Last time, we looked at how our microservices can benefit from a service mesh that exports monitoring, logging, and tracing data to Stackdriver. Now, let's add our own telemetry with custom metrics. When considering adding metric instrumentation to your applications, you generally have three options to choose from. Your first option is to use the Stackdriver monitoring API to send metrics and data points to Stackdriver directly. This is what the Stackdriver monitoring agent does. However, you should know that this API is low-level and proprietary, and at this point, we rarely recommend using it directly. Let's look at some more extensible and easier-to-use options. Your second option is to use Prometheus. It's an open-source monitoring solution. Because using Prometheus involves more than just instrumenting your code, we'll come back to this in our next episode. Your third option, and the one we recommend for creating your own custom metric instrumentation, is OpenCensus. It's a single distribution of libraries that collect metrics and distributed traces from your services. Let's look at how to use it to create custom metrics and Stackdriver. We'll use Node.js for this example. First, we need to install the two required packages, OpenCensus itself and the Stackdriver exporter. We'll do that by installing the packages with npm install at the command line or including them as part of the Docker file. Next, we'll include these packages in our code. This needs to be done at the very top of the file before any other code. We are now ready to start creating metrics. But let's review the basic concepts of the OpenCensus data model first. To start, we'll need a view. It'll describe how to collect and aggregate individual measurements. Views can be thought of as the time series we'll be adding points to later. Next, we'll use measures to describe how the data points will be recorded. We'll also specify an aggregation, which is a function to summarize the data. Finally, we'll create measurements. These will be our actual data points. We'll need to use the view we created to aggregate them, otherwise they'll get dropped on ingest. Now that we've covered the data model, let's walk through the code we'll need to write to actually create and send metrics. We'll put a link to the repo with my actual code and a detailed solution paper in the video description. First, we'll define our export interval and create the measure. This is where we define the metric that we'll be sending to Stackdriver. The key things here are the fact that it's going to be an N64 value and the name of the description of the metric. Next, we'll use that definition to actually register the metric with Stackdriver. We're calling the createView method to create the view and then the registerView method to actually register it. Note that I'm using the last value aggregation type. This means that only the last value that was captured during the export interval will be sent. You can also use distribution, count, and sum aggregations. After that, we'll register the Stackdriver exporter. This is the mechanism that'll send the metrics to the Stackdriver monitoring backend. Finally, we are ready to create actual data points. We do that by referring to the measure we already created and specifying a value. We are finally ready to run our code and send the metric data to Stackdriver. And there it is. I can see the metric in Metrics Explorer, it has the name I assigned it, and it's showing the last value that was generated when I ran the code. This can be an easy way to expose additional information about the performance and health of your application to Stackdriver, thanks to OpenCensus. Thank you for joining me today, and come back next time when we'll look at another approach to custom metrics with Prometheus. That's it for this episode. This is the Stack Doctor. Stay healthy out there.